So Alex Jones gets banned on Twitter, and it's unbelievable now because Larry Klayman is joining me. Founder of Judicial Watch has now launched the new website, freedomwatchusa.org. He is trying to get the White House's attention because he wants to take on Mueller. And we're going to be rejoined by Alex Jones on the next segment with Larry Klayman. But Larry, I mean, I feel like the problem, and Alex makes the point that, and I do think he's right, this is really about censoring the message before the midterm. But in the long term, I feel like the biggest problem you have with the lawsuit that you're about to launch that we're going to talk about here against these social media giants, I feel like your biggest problem is that you get new evidence and new material that you have to add to your case every day.
Oh, and that's good, actually. I won't have to amend the complaint. But as you know, I'm a former antitrust lawyer. I am, in part, still an antitrust lawyer. I was with the antitrust division when we broke up AT&T back in the Reagan administration. And the case that I filed is for restraint of trade under Sherman 1 of the antitrust laws. In other words, what they're doing, all of these companies, whether it's Facebook, Twitter, Google, YouTube, Instagram, others, they're colluding. They have conspired to restrain trade. And they're doing it either expressly or they're doing it in parallel. It's called conscious parallelism. And we have a strong case. And it's really a disgrace that Freedom Watch, my group, has to do that when the antitrust division of the Justice Department sits there twiddling its thumbs with Jeff Sessions, who does nothing anyway, on top of it. And just yesterday says, oh, I'm going to meet with state's attorney generals. What does he need state's attorney generals for? This is interstate commerce, and he's got complete control over his department with the antitrust division. So I hope that they'll join us in this case, and we can get rid of this problem real quick. I have one other quick comment. If you've been banned from Twitter today, I suspect that that other little Twitter, Marco Rubio, may be behind that as well in terms of what happened yesterday.
Yeah, yeah, it could be Rubio, Dorsey. It's really, I mean, whoever it is, CNN, again, it really comes down to now. And I want to get into what you just said so that the audience understands, and even I understand what you're talking about, but I think I do. But first, let me read these headlines, and then you get back to what you're talking about here. You've got the Facebook COO yesterday, Sheryl Sandberg, admitting things I couldn't even believe. Like, she says, we use alternative facts to combat fake news. They admit that they're having a positive outcome with nationwide and international elections. Well, what the heck does that mean? And then, as you just mentioned, Jeff Sessions, or at least people are saying Sessions, is going to do something about this social media censorship, or at least is looking into it. I guess we'll find out whether or not anything is going on with that. But it's like they're trying to pull this Jedi mind trick, Larry, where Sheryl Sandberg gets up there and is like, yes, we are trying to fight fake news, and we're trying to fight bad actors, and we're trying to fight election interference on our social media platforms. This is good. But, like, the real translation here is they're censoring conservatives, they're the arbiters of truth, and they're meddling in elections. But because they rephrase it and paint it like they're helping the issues, they get away with it. Is that what you're talking about here?
Yes, and they're not just meddling in elections. They're trying to change the fabric of the country. They want the country to move far left. They are far leftists. Most of them come from Silicon Valley, San Francisco, Northern California area. And this is a way they can do it. You know, it was the printing press, Owen, during the revolution that mobilized the colonies to have a Declaration of Independence, to wage a revolution, and to form a new nation. And they see that they're tremendously powerful in changing not just election results, but also the minds of the American people, and to get them agitated, to get the Antifas, to get the Black Lives Matters, to get other vigilantes out there to push back physically. And of course, this is also a way of doing it mentally. So it is a huge conspiracy, but it's also a restraint of trade. And that's why I filed this antitrust case. And, you know, forget about the Justice Department. Like I said, Sessions is just another example of him pushing something off, making it look like he's doing something, you know, as he tried to do with the U.S. attorney in Utah over the Hillary Clinton email scandal. Nothing's happening there. The guy's a complete disgrace. He's a loser. And he himself is under investigation, which is why he's buried his head in the sand. Mueller is investigating his alleged Russian collusion and obstruction of justice. And this is why We need the support here because this is expensive to take on these media giants. We are David against Goliath. And I hope people will go to freedomwatchusa.org and support us with tax-deductible contributions. Support you because you'll need it now. Your revenue stream has been obviously affected. And people like Alex need to be able to speak. This president would not be president without Alex. And the president
or just in general, alternative news on the internet, just in general, you know, and people like yourself. So we've got 3 minutes left of this segment. What is, I mean, because Jack Dorsey, he somehow has $6 billion. Zuckerberg has $66 billion. I'd like to have a hearing on how they made that money. But regardless, the point is they have unlimited funding. They can hire as many lawyers as they want. They can fight this. But we have to have funding and lawyers to fight this back. And that is the challenge. So what do you need right now when it comes to freedomwatchusa.org and what you're doing with this lawsuit? And where can people go to get that information and help you?
We need at least to raise $100,000 quickly because this is going to be a big fight at the level of the motions to dismiss, which clearly will be made. Lawyers always file them. And they can go to freedomwatchusa.org, freedomwatchusa.org, donate, it's tax deductible. But I need to hire more lawyers. We need to ramp up. I'm inviting people into the lawsuit. InfoWars is welcome to come in as a co-plaintiff along with Freedom Watch. And we need to take these people apart legally before they take us apart. Legally. And I might also add, Owen, is that I may even amend this case into a racketeering case, Racketeering and Corrupt Organizations Act. This is a racketeering enterprise by these various social media companies. And I might say that when I filed this case in Washington, D.C., in theory, we drew a good judge. We drew a Trump-appointed judge. We'd be dead in the water with a Clinton-appointed or Obama-appointed judge. So hopefully this guy, Judge McFadden, will give us a fair shake here. And I would think that he would. He has a good reputation.
Yeah, and the time span for this is obviously very short with the midterms coming up in just 60 days. And they're just, I mean, they're ramping up. It's like they don't even care. Trump has said it's illegal. Trump's campaign manager said they're looking into it. Others have said they're looking into it. You're trying to get lawsuits going and other proceedings. So they just double down. They just double down. They just try to pull a Jedi mind trick and say, oh, yes, We're fighting fake news and bad actors and Russians and meddling. No, we know what they're doing. And isn't it pathetic, Larry? I think that yesterday was the best example and an overall of all the hearings with the social media giants. Isn't it just pathetic, this Congress, the 115th Congress? What an embarrassment this Congress is.
That was a dog and pony show. It was ridiculous. It was for show, not for dough. And you know, I saw what happened with Marco Rubio. I'm from Florida. I actually ran for his seat for 6 years before he had that seat. And I'm not jealous of him at all. I prefer to be doing what I'm doing right now. But I didn't win. But Marco Rubio is a two-faced, and it was a pun that I was saying before, Twitter. Okay, I was disgusted at the way he behaved with Alex. And frankly, you know, this is what he is. You know, he plays to the media. He's a phony. And frankly, nearly all of them.
Yeah. Like he's going to sit there and say, oh, Infowars.com, I've never heard of your site, dude. Yeah, right, Marco. What a fraud. Totally exposed. Larry Klayman, freedomwatchusa.org. Help him fight the big tech censorship.